See, I got the thing is with me, you dig, I need to know some more about it. I wish you had some more literature about the education thing, yeah. Because, you dig, as far as we're concerned, the struggle, the way we look at struggle, is that this depends on the education thing, you dig.
Well, the whole thing.
No, but in the end, this does. You can form this with no education.
Not the way we're talking about forming it. You know, right. We're talking about forming it, right. You know, it's not on the paper. We didn't write it on the paper.
Form it right with no education. No. Let me give you an example. Yomo Kenyatta formed the excellent revolution with no education. And on the day of the end thing, Yomo told the motherfucker, I said, well, you know, you've been educated to hate the enemy, but I'm your brother. I helped you lead the revolution. Now I'm more oppression. Another example, Papa Doc in Haiti. Papa Doc in Haiti hated everything white. Man, you couldn't put this white paper in front of Papa Doc's face. But he moved all the white people out and he took over and be oppressed. He did. Cause no education. And the people that have been educated, they just said that we don't hate the motherfucking white people. We hate the oppressors, whether he be white, black, brown, or yellow. We got to know your educational program to find out what is going to be in the finale. A lot of people, what Yomo Kenyatta is called not a never revolutionary, but an ex-revolutionary. So it's Papa Doc. They brought on successful revolution. That thing in under my mind was a bitch. Bantu freedom fighters, all that kind of action. What we're saying is, it is the end. But you don't judge Castro now. You can't do it. Nobody in this room could judge whether Castro's going to be a revolutionary or not. You know what I mean? We're talking about things, you know what I mean? Yeah, with China, the People's Republic, and even at the stage they're in now, talking about even going on further into a communistic state. That's what we're talking about. That was a revolutionary. So we got to understand here the educational program that you have to be able to figure out whether it will go on the right lines, where the people will end up in a situation where they can be able to really control themselves. You understand what I'm saying? With no education, the people take this local foundation and start stealing money because they won't be really educated to why it's the people's thing anyway. You understand what I'm saying? With no education, you have neo-colonialism instead of colonialism like you got in Africa 9, like you got in Haiti. So what we're talking about is there has to be an educational program. That's very important. As a matter of fact, we just going to put with us that a person has to go through 6 weeks of our political education before he can consider himself a member of the party, able to even run down ideology for the party. Why? Because if they don't have an education, then they're nowhere. You get what I'm saying? They're nowhere because they don't even know why they're doing what they're doing. You might get people caught up in an emotionalist movement. You understand me? You might get them caught up in because they're poor and they want something. And then if they're not educated, they want more. And before you know it, they'll be capitalists. And before you know it, we'll have Negro imperialists.